and I'm upside down. So the line run is done and it went quite well, and it's a misty morning. It's only 20 past 8. We're going to be there early, which is not a bad thing.
It is the same road.
Do our first show today to three people, the world premiere of the Red Balloon, to three people.
They're going to love it.
Maybe it's just one person brought them by accident, or maybe brought them for the wrong show. Hello! We're here again. Nothing's changed apart from we're another year older. There's the Hippodrome looking in a sorry state. It's graffiti all over the front of it now. And of course, just like last year, we're too early. We'll have any of our posters up inside, just like there wasn't last year. No way of telling. Because that's the door in, and there ain't no one here. We're T-E-C-H-I-N-G. We're teching. Well, I am. Tony's gone to park the car. Joe's gone to the toilet, I think. We've just teched the radio show, just the two of us, and I'm delighted with how that's working. And now I've got to clear the stuff and we're going to tech for the Red Balloon. Shut up. We're about to start for an audience of three. Maybe four, but probably three. Where's the Red Balloon gone? No, seriously, where's the Red Balloon? Where's the Red Balloon? I know, I'm looking for it here. I put it up a minute ago, stuck behind the...
What's the balloon got in it?
Helium. Oh, for fuck's sake, I put it under there. It must have moved. You don't have the balloon.
Give me the... With the balloon.
No, you don't.
I can't often come on with the balloon and bop you on the head.
Not at the start.
Not
at the very start. We've got to come and say hello, hello.
Yeah, but I go off that way.
Oh, I'm with you. Yeah, all right.
Bit.
Idiot. Idiot. Oh, here we go. For just a few people. Didn't film anything yesterday because we were too busy. Now it's Sunday and we got an almost full house for Red Blue. Here's Joe. Joe's our tech, and she's not only our tech, she's an almost unpaid member of cast in the Laurel
Pretty
and Hardy
much.
Radio show. Which is just like being a real actress, isn't it?
It almost is. Almost. If I was actually with other actors, it would be better, but you know.
Shut your face. There's Tim in the corner over there. Tim has nothing to do with the show, but he's filming it today. So if you ever see a film, hello. There we are, in the darkness. That's my quality of filming. And today, unlike yesterday, we've got laying out, my costume's going to be on this side, rather than, it's like a jumble cell. It's because you were talking too fast, you were so scared. No, what we're going to do, we're going to give them to the kids as they leave.
Oh, okay, great. So
rather than actually,
work
yeah, we'll keep them backstage. Or we can keep them back with you. No, I don't want to bed. Well, you might, because you know what you like. Danger, woman. So here's the backstage. Oh, she's giving us a light. It's lucky and ducky there. Cool, we'll be fine. Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I better blow some of those balloons up myself, because that would really help. Yes, yes, yes. And here we are about to begin the second day of the Laurel and Hardy radio show with my amazing homemade mics. I put a tea strainer on it. Thing. I'd like you to meet today's cast.
Does that mean we're not in the game? replaced.
Larger than yesterday's audience for the red blue.
Can you introduce them?
No, I don't want to introduce them. Starring Mr. Jonathan Cottrell, Mrs. Samantha Weems, Mr. Ian Creese, a piece of shit, and Mr. Timothy Leary.
Hello.
Tune in, turn on, and do it the other way around, and drop out. Also known as Mr. Timothy Brown.
I prefer the first one. It's my official
The
name.
Weedy, downtrodden, ineffectual person in a boxing ring in Bull.
Oh, I see where you're going with that.
Yeah, with Bull, it's a little village outside Huntington. There's Joe again.
Wednesday, 15th of May, Leatherhead.
By the time no one sees this, it'll be gone.
Hello. Hello. Oh, hello. I'm half relaxed after show. I want to tell you that I was very good in show and people loved me. Red Bloom went for a while. I was best in it, and then they did Lossy Hardy. And I sat on the table, and I was best in it too. Yeah. And open rail recorder, it broke down, and all the tape went way, 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 all over the floor. And I did that, because I hate them. Yeah.
This is the glamour of touring. This is the second weekend of doing the Red Balloon and the Laurel and Hardy radio show. There's been a few weeks gap between the two. Tony's been at a show, I've been at Gibraltar, and he's currently getting off for 25 minutes late, and this is worrying because I've texted and sent a PM and there's no reply.
Alright, we can do the show here.
Yeah, thanks Percy, that's helpful.
Oh, I'm glad I'm helpful.
Right, going to start another show in a minute. Shut your face. There's probably about six people in today, but there we are, that's how it goes. We just do it as we do it. Ooh. Balloons there. Right, red balloon one, alright. All 14. A prop and costume. Loss going on during it, but otherwise it was okay. Comedy ad-libbing going on. So we're going to start the Laurel and Hardy in a minute. Got a gate crusher.
And, shut super up. Fan.
Shut up. Leave me alone. Just so our actor's over there. And John. It's outside. See, it's absolutely packed with thousands of people waiting to come in. Yeah.
Well, welcome to Brighton Fringe today. Our last day of performing.
Excellent.
Here's Joe.
Joe's butt, anyway. Hello.
Hello, Joe. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm feeling very macho today.
I can hear it in your voice, how macho you are.
I'm a man. Are you looking forward to our last show?
I am. I actually love Red Balloon. It makes me have a little wah-wah every time.
Should I shut the door?
Oh, the kids,
please
the kids
do.
Are coming?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. I know, I'm aware of it. Thanks. We cheat. We cheat. Look, you think it was a real thing from the... No, it's fake.
Yeah, we're just shouting.
5 minutes.
Greg,
we can
have all the lights up.
Yes,
thank you.
Woo! So our last show, the Laurel and Hardy radio show, if you want to compare the views of each one of our stunning actors and John... As they looked at the start of the run and as they look now. You see, they look entirely the same.
We've got the mad staring eyes now.
Tony's lost his jacket. Because there's always got to be something. Joe's just...
Joe.
Yeah, just Joe.
Yeah. She's
amazing. We like Joe. We want to keep her.
Why not?
Tied up in a cellar. Feed her once a month.
It's kind of the other way around.
Okay. What, tied up once a month and fed in the cellar? The boys are down there. Now, the news is that apparently we're almost a sellout. Someone say that's been the case for many a year. That's good, isn't it? Yay! Last show. And the last show we did at the Red Balloon today, at least at Brighton, went really nicely. It was a really nice, really nice show.
Your old man.
Yes, they did.
I don't know what it's filming out there, but I'm just panning camera around outside of door. So hopefully that's showing some people waiting outside.
You can't see anything at the moment. Tony's eating the audience. He's on a training course with Mr. Pie.
Hello. You mentioned my name.
Yes, how are you?
I'm very well. How are you?
I'm all right, Mr. Pie. Thank you for asking.
Have you eaten a pie today?
I've had a sausage roll. A vegan one.
Again, not a pie.
It would be a pie if you changed the shape.
You're trying to hoodwink me.
Yes.
Well done.